this video, we'll learn about one-way ANOVA, analysis of variance, which is used for tests of hypothesis that three or more populations have the means that are equal by analyzing sample variances. It is called one-way ANOVA because we use data categorized by one factor or treatment. So there is one characteristic used to separate the sample data into different categories. The term treatment is used because early applications of ANOVA involved agricultural experiments in which different plots of farmlands were treated with different treatments, fertilizers, seed types, insecticides, and so on. So let's look at the example of using one-way ANOVA, analysis of variance.
Data for this example is from 121 subjects. Data are measured from children in two consecutive years, and the children were living close to a lead smelter. Lead column is blood lead level group. 1 equal to low lead level, blood lead levels less than 40 micrograms per 100 milliliters in both years. 2 equal medium lead level, blood lead levels greater or equal to 40 micrograms per 100 milliliters in exactly 1 of 2 years. And 3 equal to high blood lead level greater or equal 40 micrograms per 100 milliliter in both years. Data are from neuropsychological dysfunction in children with chronic low-level lead absorptions by these authors, published in Lancet Medical Journal, Volume 1, number 7909. We will use this data of the performance IQ scores in the column IQ performance and significance level of alpha equals 0.05 to test the claim that the three samples come from populations with means that are all equal. Let's first check the requirements. In order to conduct a one-way ANOVA test, the following requirements must be met. First, the populations have distributions that are approximately normal. To check for the normality of the distribution, we will build QQ plots. Let's go to Graph, QQ plot, select column IQ performance. We want to group it by the lead column, compute. The distribution of the first level, level 1, looks approximately normal. The distribution of level 2, medium level, looks approximately normal too, with one outlier on the left side. And the distribution of lead level 3 looks normal as well. So the first requirement is met. The second requirement, the populations have the same variance, sigma squared, or standard deviation, sigma. Let's find summary statistics. Go to STAT, summary stats, columns, select column IQ performance, group by lead level. We want to find variance and standard deviation. Compute. We can see that standard deviation is not very different, so the second requirement also met. The third requirement. The samples are simple random samples of quantitative data. The data are quantitative, and on the basis of the study design, we can treat the samples as simple random samples. Third requirement is also met. Requirement number 4. The samples are independent of each other. The samples are independent of each other. The performance IQ scores are not matched in any way. And the last requirement for one-way ANOVA test, the different samples are from populations that are categorized in only one way. The three samples are from the populations categorized according to the single factor of lead level, low, medium, and high. So all requirements are met, and we can proceed with the hypothesis testing. Null hypothesis is that all three means from the three populations are equal. Alternative hypothesis is that at least one of the means is different from the others. We will use alpha level of 0.05 to test this hypothesis, and we will use the help of StatCrunch. Go to Stat, ANOVA, One Way. Choose values in the single column because all our values are located in the single column IQ performance. Factor in column lead. Leave everything else as it is. Compute. Here are the results. In one-way ANOVA, we use new test statistic, F statistic. Let's write it down. F is equal 4.07 rounded to two decimals, and p-value is equal 0.0195. We can round it to two decimals as well, 0.02. We will talk about F statistic in a minute. Right now, let's look at p-value and compare it to significance level of alpha. P-value is less than alpha of 0.05, so we reject the null hypothesis of equal means and say that there is sufficient evidence to warrant rejection of the claim that the three samples come from populations with means that are all equal. Using the samples of measurements listed, we conclude that those values come from populations having means that are not all the same. Let's look at the means. As you can see, one mean is slightly higher than the other two means. Now let's go back to test statistic, F statistic, and look at F distribution. There is a different F distribution for each different pair of degrees of freedom for numerator and denominator. The F distribution is not symmetric, it is right skewed. Values of F distribution cannot be negative. The exact shape of the F distribution depends on the two different degrees of freedom. The value of F is found by dividing the variance between samples by variance within samples. The numerator of the F test statistic measures variation between the samples. The estimate of variance in the denominator depends only on the sample variances and is not affected by the differences among sample means.
I hope that was helpful. For more videos on statistics topics, check the playlist JB ABC Statistics on my channel. I'll see you next time.